Thank you. familiar music by Mozart, one of his greatest operas, was perhaps a little unfamiliar right at the very end. We played the concert ending that the composer himself wrote, but is not so widely known. The original overture, of course, ends quietly in another key, and we start the first act. That music, though, was written after the other two works that we're going to play for you today. Carl Philipp Emanuel, one of the most famous of Bach's many sons, wrote symphonies all through his life. But the one we're going to play now is the first of his final quartet of symphonies, his most resplendent, colourful, and instrumentated with some very prominent parts for the wind. His music is completely different from both Haydn and Mozart. A few seconds of this music and you will know that you're in another world. It is, like Haydn often was, very daring, with some very unexpected key changes and little details in the music. I love this music. I think it has a great energy and originality. Particularly interesting is the fact that the slow movement is scored for just very few instruments and is in a very foreign key to the main key of D major. It was a great experiment, a great challenge to the ear, the way he does that, with the violins just giving a little light pizzicato accompaniment. But this music is original. It's unlike anyone else. And if you've never heard it before, I hope you'll enjoy it.
Thank you.
Everybody, by the time CPE Bach wrote that symphony, Haydn had composed about 70 of his own. Of course, if he'd written about half the number of symphonies that he did end up writing, he would still be one of the greatest composers that's ever lived. Each one of these symphonies has such a character of its own, a story behind it very often. Some of them we know, some of them we don't. This one is not so well known, number 64, and it has this intriguing Latin little quotation at the beginning, Tempora, mutantur. Now it appears, we're not even sure quite when the symphony was written, perhaps 1773, so a few years before that CPE Bach work. And Tempora, mutantur exists on a set of parts, so we assume that Haydn actually thought of it like this and he had some meaning in this title. It's very strange. But at the beginning of the 17th century, there was an Elizabethan poet, a Welshman called John Owen, and he wrote this Latin inscription in full that everybody knew, and it was later translated. And it seemed to me that in these days that we're going through, it had a little relevance and appropriateness. One might translate it as, "The times are changed, and in them changed are we. How so? Man, as times grow worse, grows worse, we see. Now, if there was a meaning for this slightly ominous little couplet in Haydn's mind, surely it is in the second movement of this great symphony that the meaning is found. The second movement is quite extraordinary, completely unusual, and you never know quite what the next bar will contain. The music seems to lose confidence, as if it breaks off. It loses its way, but it fundamentally is music of great beauty, as you will see. The first movement is extremely full of initiative, information, creativity, an extraordinary, small, short first movement. His orchestration is amazing. You'll see that it's not written for a very large orchestra, but everybody is used with colour and with virtuosity. So here it is, the 64th symphony by Haydn, Tempora, mutantur.
Thank you. Thank you. I hope, like me, you're all feeling a little bit more positive about the future. Finally, there's a light at the end of this long, challenging, difficult tunnel. Thank goodness we've had music to keep us going. Music, so incredibly powerful. It has the ability to unite us all, to heal us all, to comfort us, to envelop us in its magic. So I hope you enjoy today's concert. This one and all the others have been provided free of charge. So I would love you to dig into your pockets, be generous and give to help us continue giving these free online concerts to you all, and to, and very importantly, support the students. So please give generously. Thank you so much. Enjoy today's concert and keep smiling. And I hope to be able to perform, sing to some of you in the very near future.